What is going on, guys? It's your boy Damon again, and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, guys, we are going to make our own DIY tarantula hide, or the DIY cork bar. For you guys that lives in the city, I do understand that, you know, you rarely see trees or something like that. That means that you are also not able to find any cork barks lying on the ground or, you know, stuff like that. So these are the stuffs that we need. I have here plastic bottle. You can use like Coca-Cola or, you know, any bottled soft drinks. Next, I have here glue. Then I also have here a scissor. And lastly, we have here a cocoa bean. Okay, this project is actually very straightforward, guys. So there's no need for you to do a lot of things or, you know, hard things. What you need to do is you just need to cut this bottle. So for kids out there, please be careful. I would strongly suggest for you to ask assistance from your brothers or sisters or older than you, okay? What I'm planning to do with this bottle will be for the arboreal, because sooner or later I'm planning to get a P. metallica. So as you guys know, that tarantula is arboreal, so they need to have some sort of cork bark or a hide. Okay, so we've managed to punch a hole in here. Now you just need to cut the top of the bottle. It actually doesn't matter if you cut this one correctly or smoothly, because at the end of the day, we're going to cover this whole bottle with cocoa bean. Now, next one will be at the bottom. So same procedure, just need to punch a hole to get it started. So here's our finished product, guys. Now it's up to you if you're going to, like, you know, do some curves in here or something like that. So for me, what I'm going to do is I will just do it like this. Still need to cut this one out. Now, like I said, guys, it actually doesn't matter if you have cut this one smoothly or correctly, because this will be covered entirely with cocoa bean. Okay, guys, so I have already cut the sides, or, you know, some sort of texture. So now what we're going to do next is we are going to make her hands dirty. So it's time to put some glue. Usually what I do is I just try to put glue on the one portion or something like that, so it won't be messy. Okay. Now we need to put the cocoa bean in here. Just like that, guys. So you can see here, there's already a cocoa bean on one portion of the plastic bottle. So we just need to do this one all over, so it will be covered up with the cocoa bean. It's actually helpful as well to spread out the glue, so there won't be any like dead spots or something like that. Just like this one, guys. You just need to do this one all over the bottle. So it's also important to compress the cocoa bean so that there won't be any spots that is not covered. So we're halfway through. Okay, guys, so I'll just fast forward this video so it won't be boring. So we're almost done, guys. So as you can see here, we have already successfully covered the bottle with the cocoa peat. Now, what we need to do next is we are going to do the same inside and we are going to dry this one. So currently it's already 9 p.m. We will just dry this one tomorrow, guys, in the morning. I also made one hide for terrestrial for my Rocky Palmas. It's actually not practical to buy some sort of a branded hide in the pet shops or something like that. If you live in the city just like me, you just need to do this one, guys. So trust me, it's cheaper. The only thing that I bought in here is just the glue and as well as the cocoa. So the rest is just reusable. So this one is just from a Coca-Cola bottle. And this one, as you can see in the start of the video, this is from energy drink or something like that.
4 to 6 more days later.
And we are back again, guys. So these are our finished products. I have finished 3 hides in here. So one will be for the terrestrial hide and 2 for the arboreal. I left them outside for about 4 days. So I guess these hides are already hard enough. So as you can hear, it's already hard. And I have also added some cocoa peat in the inside as well. Now I have here another experiment. So I tried to put cocoa peat layer on the outer side so that I'll be able to determine if which one is going to dry first. So will it be the one with the both sides, I mean the outside and inside, or will it be the outer layer first? Then after that we're going to add another cocoa peat in the inside. Now based on my observation, so I guess that this experiment actually works well because I have here another arboreal hide. So I already covered the outside and also the inside. However, the inside actually is still not hard enough. So as you can see here, there's still cocoa peat from the inside. It still need to dry outside or something like that. But yeah, I guess that should be all for this video, guys. So here are our finished product with our DIY tarantula hide. If you enjoy this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more videos where we talk about pets and gaming. See ya!